for this opportunity that you have given me. Amen. Amen. And I said thank you to the leadership of the Christian community. Amen. Amen. Before we start, let us pray. Gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you, Chief of Glory, for this man of God. Indeed, it's by your powerful God that, Lord, you have allowed us to overshadow and be in such a manner, all because of your name, O God. Indeed, this name that is above every other name, O God, through this name that you have light and you are light to your God. In Jesus' mighty name, Lord, may you speak our hearts to God. May you prepare our hearts to God.
To be defined in God.
we say that we are deceived, we say we know God. But if we were to know God, amen, we would love Him, we would give Him respect, we would desire to know Him, and we will live by the character of Him. Amen.
Amen.
1 John 4:8.
Praise the Lord.
Then they said to him, "Where is your father?" Jesus answered, you had known me, you would have known my Father also. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
They were so sure to say they know everything about the law. A up to Z, they were more like the law keepers. And they thought to be righteous. Amen. No wonder we were warned to say, let not our righteousness be like those of the Pharisees that stand in the corner so that they may be seen. No. Amen. The reason we are discouraged from the righteousness of the Pharisees is because they never knew the source of their righteousness. They never knew God, but they were busy practicing the things of God. Hallelujah. If they had known God, they would have loved. If they had known God, they would have respect for the Lord. Amen. They would not have been self-seeking attention to people to say, by their effort, we should know. They would have added money to say, it's all to God. Hallelujah. So I urge you all that be defined in love. Amen.
Amen.
Let it be something that shall spring out of you, that when people look at you, they will see the love of God in you. Amen. Amen. That they will see you practicing love of God. Amen.
Amen.
Jeremiah 2, verse 8. The same with us, amen. To be defined by this word, amen. It for us to know who God is. Hallelujah. We have to know who God is. So there are some steps, 3 steps, for us to get to know God as we are being defined by Him. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
But while there is a thought, it becomes a problem. we have to address such issues in our lives. I mean, we have to address our notes. We have to address our faults, our flaws, our weaknesses. Hallelujah.
Praise
we have to identify them. We have to search them. Because with the heart, if you're filled with guilt, your heart is not free. You feel condemned. It's going to limit God's hand upon you. The Bible clearly tells us to say there is therefore no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. But because of guilt, hallelujah, because of the sin that you did, you feel condemned, you feel guilty in all that is being plotted upon your hearts, hindering you to know who God is in your life. Let us clear our hearts, amen. Let us remove, hallelujah, all those thoughts. Let us read from the book of
praise the Lord.
conform yourself to things of God. Paul had to pray to say, that I may know you, amen, that I may know you, and the power that is in your resurrection, hallelujah. Pray that you know God more, and likewise in your time, thinking of who you are going to embrace, hallelujah. Start living life for others. If you are so much paying attention to how they see you, hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
It's your life. We live but once. So it means you'll be giving that brother a double life. He's living his part, you're also living for him. Where was your life? Remember the exact day where you will be saying to say, watch out, you know, when we shall be shown. It changed our control. What are you going to receive if you are conforming yourself to the pattern of this world? Let not this fear of rejection be overwhelming us. Hallelujah. But let us overcome it. Remember the cross, he said, I have paid it all.
Yes.
Amen. He said, it is finished. It is finished. Let us remember, amen, as we are after the heart of God, as we are willing to know him, let us remember what God did on the cross, when he said, it is finished. Even if you are rejected, God is embracing. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Even if they reject you, hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
It shouldn't be a matter to us. Hallelujah. At this point, well, we reached. It shouldn't be something but that bothers us a lot, that we even fail to eat, we even fail to achieve goals that should have meaning to your life because you want to spend your money on buying an outfit just to fit into a certain group. No. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Remember about Hagar. Amen. She was rejected, but God never forsake her. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. So they may forget you. Remember, there is a God who is your sustainer always. Hallelujah. Let us not have this fear of rejection. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
We have to understand what takes us true in our hearts. Hallelujah. As we want to know, we have to understand what takes up our room in our hearts. Psalms 10 verse 4. The wicked in his proud countenance does not seek God. God is in none of his thoughts. Hallelujah. The wicked in his proud countenance does not seek God. God is none of his thoughts. Amen. Shuo Ochelevi. Upfumaka Chele.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. Let there be a difference. I don't want us to be defined to say we don't change our message. No. Amen. I want us to be defined by the value and substance of God. The value and substance of God in our lives. The acknowledgement that we give to Him each and every morning to say He is God. That beside Him there is no man. That indeed is suffering might be in my life. Amen. More busy on our homes. Today we are valuing the definition. Amen. We have to admit our needs. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Many are the times People change.
Praise the Lord.
When you change your mind, when you allow God to change your mind, He says, be transformed by the renewal of your consciousness. So faith begins to make sense. All those things that don't make sense in the physical, you begin to see their importance. Amen. And that's reading Romans 8:16. Anything can happen.
God. God. Praise the Lord.
Do not let your hearts envy sinners, but be zealous for the fear of the Lord all the day. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
We have talked about this. Do not conform your mindset to the pattern of this world. Do not envy. Careful, Sierra, brother. Be zealous for the fear of the Lord. You don't know how that person has acquired that fear because you are seeking out for different people in this world. Or if you don't want to feel about friendship, so that's what we should share. Don't envy such, but be zealous for the fear of the Lord. Not to say that it is wrong to say that I give hope, and it is He who is going to provide for it. Hallelujah. So do not be anxious about getting things, being conformed to the pattern of the world. No, hallelujah. But seek after the fear of the Lord. Be in alignment with the word of God. You need to stop thinking about what you are thinking and let God intervene. Hallelujah. Stop thinking about that which you are thinking in a particular plan B. Let God align thoughts. God is ever interested in things that happen in the heart. We can deceive others, we can fool others, acting all good, doing the right things, but inside it's the contrary action. So if we allow our inside man to be aligned to the word of God, then Jeremiah 29 verse 11 will come in to say, the plans that He has for you are to prosper you, not to cause you harm, but to give you a good future. Hallelujah. You are to be conformed to the pattern of the way of God. Conform yourself to the definition of God. Don't just say scriptures thinking you have intended life, but not to say these scriptures are the ones that testify about me. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
See to it to say these scriptures are the ones that are helping you to know God. Amen. Not for you to say scripture. Be like the rulers in the time of Jesus Christ, who knew everything by them they never knew Christ. to accept the God factor in you. Hallelujah. You have to accept the God factor in you. The factor that is going to lead you to success. Accepting the God factor is accepting and believing to say, yes, He is and is the reward of all those that did it. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.